Hello, here we are on a beautiful day in beautiful Wendy Park. Lake Erie's over to my right and then leading, of course, to the whole wide world's oceans. My name is Fran Mentch. I'm the co-chair of the Northeast Ohio Sierra Club Water Committee. I'm here today speaking on behalf of the environment, but I'm not speaking as a Sierra Club. The concern that I want to discuss has to do with plastics. Plastics pollution. We all come at this and experience plastic pollution in different ways. Always the personal becomes the political, but we all are drawn to the concern over plastics in the environment, and no matter what level, if it's clogging your drain, if it's in fact having impact on wildlife, or if you're someone who is aware from the chemical composition of some plastics and their potential for impact on public health. So my goal is to just talk about plastics and plastic pollution, because you're all aware of it, but the more you talk about it and then when you think about it, pull it into your personal life, you become more aware. It's when something is pointed out, we've all lived through this, someone points something out to you and then you're aware of it. Before somebody shows you the bird's nest or the plastic pollution, you walk by it. But once it's brought to your attention, you become very aware of it and begin to think about how it is that it moves about in your world. The political discourse, again, on the ideological spectrum, about keeping plastics out of the environment, about legislating against plastic bags or whatever, it usually comes down to an argument over monies and jobs. And in many of these issues, it's very complicated. As I say, where the money comes from, where it goes, how long it stays, who it ends up in benefiting, all those things are extremely complicated. And we know from political science, voters look for a shortcut. They look for a heuristic. I don't want to get all this complicated. I want something really easy. So the heuristic always comes down to money and jobs. Money is taxes and jobs. Well, that is pulled into the political discourse about plastics too, and they will say people are working. They are working. They have a job making plastics, whatever it is, and they'll say, you know, the taxes from those jobs are not just help. They're helping everybody. So they'll say if you pull the plastic bags out of the environment, plastic, you're removing jobs. Well, again, you have to dig deeper. It is somebody's job, but behind that is a large manufacturing enterprise. And they have lobbyists, and there's always protecting their, we all protect our interests, right? Corporations protect their self-interest as we all do individually. So that's part of the discourse. However, it is more complicated than just somebody losing jobs, because those people, you don't know, number one, could they find another job? Will not the shift in thinking and in use of plastics have impact, and the jobs won't disappear, but they will in fact shift. So you have to think about that as a consideration. Again, that's complicated, but it is true, as we know from shift in energy in general, that the jobs went from one sector to another, and there are these, quote, these green jobs. And you don't know how it would act itself out in the environment either. I mean, if you own a grocery store and you spend less money on purchasing plastic bags and dealing with them, you may in fact think, I'm going to improve my quality, the experience of my customer. You might hire somebody to help facilitate packing or whatever, all these other things that we look for quality and pleasure in our lives. So that's part of the discourse, this money and jobs. If you follow that, you'll see it doesn't always turn out to work out the way that the argument is sold. I've lived through that several times as an activist, and money, mm-hmm. usually jobs, he agrees with me, usually jobs shift from one place to the other. So the other part of the political discourse is nanny government, right? The government shouldn't have to get involved in telling people, getting that involved in people's lives. So there's an ideological stance also. It's just keep government out of our lives. The market will solve the problem. And in many ways, that is true, including the plastics. The most effective way to change people's behavior is to, in fact, legislate against it. You know, it's going to cost you 10 cents if you use a plastic bag. People will they'll bring reusable bags and they will use less bags. But back to this, the market will solve all of the problems. In many ways, the market In fact, not in many ways. In truth, the market is leading this argument against plastics. For I don't know how long, I guess over a decade, you can't get bags from Costco. You can't get plastic bags from, if you get them from Aldi's or Save-A-Lot, they charge you. I think maybe they're not even available. I don't know exactly what goes on with Whole Foods, but it's the same type of thing where the private sector is saying, we don't want to provide plastic bags for free, because if something's free, it gets wasted, right? So people are willing to bring their own or to pay for bags. So the private sector is really leading in this way. So that's another argument. That's another way to look at this on the ideological spectrum. Okay, so what's going on locally, legislatively? The local is so important. People are much more interested, and we're bombarded with what goes on the federal level and even on the state level. But really, what impacts your life, even though maybe it's not as interesting or sexy, what really impacts your life are local issues, local legislation. And in Cuyahoga County, there was a bill, legislation that was proposed was co-sponsored by Dale Miller and Sonny Simon. These are two county council representatives who have expressed concern about plastic bags and wanting to reduce their presence in our environment. So they did propose legislation. The last time I spoke with one of them, I was told that it has not been brought back out to the full council for them to vote on. It became, complicated politically, but this would be something that you could do. You can contact your Cuyahoga County Council member. This is someone who is representing you to the Cuyahoga County Council. Or you could contact Armin Budish, who is the county executive. So that would be something, you could ask them to bring forward this legislation once again, that you feel that reducing the use of plastic bags in the county is essential. They were going to reduce the use by incentivizing people not to buy plastic bags at stores because it would cost them 10 cents. There were some exemptions. There were people who would not have to pay that fee, but essentially you have to pay 10 cents per bag, and the monies would go towards paying the merchants for the costs that are of course part of that, them doing that and collecting the fee, and then the remainder was going to work on environmental issues in the county. So please contact your county council representative. It is good also to contact Dale Miller and Sonny Simon, since they are co-sponsoring. That will encourage them. They can say they've heard from people in the county and they're concerned about this, and that's why they're pursuing it again. So any of those things are very helpful. A phone call, an email, whatever's easiest for you. You certainly could do that. The other thing is of interest, and again, this is dormant at this point, but this was really interesting. Shortly after county council proposed this, and this is something that's going on throughout the state of Ohio. It's not just here. As I said, we're lagging far behind, but through other areas of Ohio, people began talking about, cities have talked about legislating against the use of plastic bags, reducing, essentially not against, I shouldn't say that, but reducing the use of plastic bags. So the Ohio Senate, right down in Columbus, wherever it is from here, they proposed a bill, Senate Bill 210, which would prohibit local governments from regulating disposable containers. So there you have it. There was an effort to reduce the use of plastic bags, but they moved forward trying to on a state level, prevent local governments from regulating disposable containers. And again, there's a solution for this. The solution would be, of course, compostables or reducing their use. But this is what goes on politically. And that's why you do want to keep on top of it. And again, you can see they probably did not initiate this legislation because individuals contacted them. This is, of course, understandably, this is a part of the economy, part of businesses banding together, and they have lobbyists and trying to promote their own self-interest. So that's why you too have to speak up. So that was something else that was going on locally. Finally, to go back to the the concept of the personal is political, always, always the personal is political. There are many things. I came to this feeling very discouraged. It's easy for me to get discouraged when I think about things on a broader level. But you can make a difference. I began to talk to places where I go to eat about reducing their use of plastic straws. Now, sometimes they cannot reduce plastic straws, the use of straws. For various reasons, they have to use straws. But they could move to using paper straws. And I found that they were very open to this. Many places, you could say, when you have water, you could say, please, I want no straw. If they bring you one, please ask them to take it back. Because that's a simple thing. I found, it was interesting to me, I brought this up in three different places. And in all three occasions, I asked to talk to the manager. I explained my concern, and they were very receptive. They said, thank you for bringing that to my attention. I never thought about that. If we don't use straws, we in fact will save money. And again, if they must use straws, which sometimes you have to, you need them, you could use a paper straw or compostable. But that's something you can do, and I think you'll be pleasantly surprised that they will be open to talking about that. The other thing is, it doesn't seem to really have a whole lot to do with it, but it does. In many ways, a lot of the packaging and the plastic pollution and the bags and so forth that we use, if we need them, I think about this when I'm shopping or making food. Like, we need a certain amount of plastics to protect our food, but There is a lot of it that is not, it has no function. It's simply like, I don't know what it is, if it's decoration, if it's habit, if it's custom. But I've had a hard time getting people not to bring a straw. I'm a little old lady, I say, please, I want water, but I don't want ice, I don't want lemon, I don't want a straw. Sometimes I tell them I'm saving the earth or whatever, but I really don't want any of those things. And they have a hard time doing that because I think they think they're cheating me some way, or they're not giving me a nice presentation. So it is an interesting thing to take on. Next time you go, just say, please don't bring me a straw. And you will find that it does have a big, big impact. It really does. So good luck to everybody in this effort as you start to bump up against the world. And on behalf of Lake Erie, I guess I say thank you.